Hello everyone, this is Mesolite Visual here. In this video, we are going to talk about how you can improve quality of architectural CAD drawings from design to construction. This video will help you to increase efficiency and productivity, to be smart and be organized, teach you how to use preset to start the new project without wasting any time. It will also show you how to automate a lot of operations and speed up the process, to understand the power of using a template to utilize best practices workflow. So if you want to improve the quality of your architectural drawings, this video has it all. You are welcome. Architecture projects go through a design process, a process that documents the project path from design to construction. It starts first with sketching to resolve and address issues from the client's functional requirements in the brief. This is where the project in most cases is getting birth. There have been evolution of architectural drawings in CAD programs to accelerate the project development process several times and making it more accurate. So to get started, we use Archicad software in our workflow, and we always utilize the use of a template to have an immediate project startup with preset views, layouts, and set of drawings. This helps us to reduce repetitive work to increase productivity and the efficiency of producing drawings. The template is a project file structure that has stored data in all 3D and 2D tools, then saved as favorites. This data revolves in all operations you are going to carry from sketches and your design to construction. Let us draw a wall in a plan view. In this operation, we use wall tool that contains commonly used presets of parameters like the wall thickness, the height, specifications of wall materials, classifications and trade code, graphic display in floor plan and sections. In this template, all the parameter data is stored and saved as favorites in all objects and tool settings. If you go through all these parameters, there is embedded information as there are categories of class from all settings. Open classification and properties section, there is a various data in this section, and be aware that this is the data we are pulling out for information like schedules, quantities, and annotations in different views like sections and elevation that we're going to demonstrate in a minute. Go to the wall settings. Under classification, there are custom-made classes of building elements. A wall is under masonry class. Then trade code is a B superstructure. The description and specification of the brickwork is, it has a parameter. Rate and cost value, just to mention the few from the list. Another important parameter are under main construction. We got a list of construction type of our wall, and then you can add reinforcement and others from the list. This data is being used to automate some of the annotation process in sections and details views. Annotation in this template is a process that is being automated. This is the data embedded in object classifications and properties we are using. Use label tool and pick saved label from favorites to speed up the workflow. The settings of these tools have been modified for you to use. Click on the wall to place annotation. In this case, we are going to annotate the plaster, core brick, and reinforcement material of this brickwork. All this information and process is saved and stored as a preset for you. You don't have time to start editing and tweaking these complex settings. For an example, let's annotate a complex view like a section. Place label in each of the elements in this view to add your annotations. The label knows what type of data to place for each and every element. Isn't this magical? If you want this template, check the link in the description below. In this workflow, schedules are a powerful document in accuracy of the building cost. The template offers a system that links these documents to extract data from all objects that assemble your building. For an example, let's use a common schedule like a door schedule. Notice that information that appears here is from classification and properties of stored parameter data from door settings. If I select one of the doors and pick the first green button to access the door from the floor plan and then door settings under classification and properties section. The class is the door. Trade code is F Carpentry, Joinery and Ironmongery. Description and specification data. The cost of the door and many more like frame, hardware set to glazing, not forgetting the manufacturer or supplier section. The background is used to put your drawings into context by adding the scene and highlight to the subject. It also helps to enhance the subject and its environment. This will allow the human eye to distinguish different elements and determine depth in the drawing. Use fill with solid white background to trace the contour edge of your elevation. Open the view settings of the elevation. Go to model display. In the model display section, the uncut elements represent surfaces of the current view of this elevation. Under fill uncut surfaces part, use surface color of the model. Check vectorial 3D hatching to represent materials. Also check shadows and make sure to control the intensity to give the drawing depth and value. You can spice it up with graphic overrides. And then lastly, add human figures and other necessary 2D information like birds and trees to add scale. We came to the end of this video, but I want to show you the last tip in 3D documents creation. We're going to do it in a style and let's create something like this. I will add the missing part of the roof by the accessories tool from the design menu, design extras, accessories and roof accessories. This tool allows us to add 3D detailed roof in the model. Go to the roof plan, draw portions we are going to cut the roof to have a cut view detail by using slab tool. Use solid element operations to subtract both slab portions to create a cut in the roof and then hide both slabs. Mark you the portion and 3D view you want to show. Convert the view into a 3D document and save the view. Go ahead and place annotations as we did previously. Thank you guys, I hope this really helped you so you can improve the quality of your drawings. Let me know if you have any questions or suggestions on what topic I should cover or clarify by commenting below. Make sure you hit that subscribe button if this really helped, and I will see you in the next video. Work smart, be creative. Cheers guys.